So, friends, in our last class, we have discussed in great detail about trait theory of leadership, and in that we have discussed that how there are certain particular kind of qualities according to trait theory of leadership which make anyone as a leader, and those are certain traits, those are certain qualities which are found there in any person since birth. Okay. But behavioral theory of leadership says something different. It says that it can be possible for anyone, that someone can become a leader later on, while there may not be some kind of leadership potential in anyone. Later on, if someone acquires, if someone learns certain particular kind of actions, then he or she can become a leader. Okay, so behavioral theory of leadership says that it is certain cluster of behaviors which make or which differentiate in between leader and non-leader. So there are two very comprehensive work, or you can say very comprehensive studies, which have been done by different agencies, different educational institutes. One of them was by Ohio State University. So it was Ohio State University's work which garnered a lot of attention. That work was very, very popular among leadership studies, among leadership scholars. So what was that work? That work says that there are two important behavioral categories. What are two important behavioral categories? The first one is initiating or task orientation. The second one is considerate people orientation. Initiating or task orientation here means what? Initiating or task orientation means that there are, particular set of behavior in any leader. So any leader knows that how to design any task, how to direct someone, to whom to assign some kind of task, and how to get it done. So there is a lot of task orientation, there is a lot of initiation, there is a lot of directiveness on the part of the leader. And in this, by doing this particular kind of behavior, there can be very good performance. The second very important behavioral category is considerate or people orientation, in which a leader is very friendly. A leader is very friendly. So there is a lot of respect, there is a lot of regard. So there is very good relationship, there is a lot of support by the leader. Okay. And there is a lot of interaction. Always a leader is approachable. Anyone can go and interact with any leader. So friends, these are two very important behavioral categories according to Ohio State University. Then the second very important work that was done by University of Michigan. University of Michigan, according to University of Michigan's work, there are two broad categories of behaviors again. What are those? One is employee oriented, another one is production oriented. So employee oriented behaviors means those particular kind of behaviors in which leader is much more interested in facilitating, increasing, having better interpersonal relationship with his follower. And in production oriented, there is a lot of emphasis by the leader on certain technicalities, how to get certain works done. But actually, it was Ohio State University's work that achieved that, grasped a lot of attention by scholars, by different managers, and that also regarding that also there have been a lot of studies also. So friends, according to recent studies, it is the mix of both initiating and considerate. Okay, so task orientation and people orientation, both of them are important. If someone wants to be a good leader, then both kind of behaviors, both kind of behavioral orientation, there must be, in order to be the best leader. Okay. So there must be people orientation also, there must be at the top task orientation also. So thank you so much. Then further we will discuss certain other topics after this.